Hello, in this video NEET Physics 2020 Solutions Continuation Part 3, 10 questions we are going to discuss. Okay, then question number 19, a capillary tube of radius R is immersed in water and water rises in it to a height H. The mass of the water in the capillary is 5 gram. Another capillary tube of radius 2R is immersed in water. The mass of water that will rise in this tube is option 1 5.0 gram, option 2 10.0 gram, option 3 20.0 gram, option 4 2.5 gram. Okay, how to do this problem? We can see in case 1 we use this formula. This is a formula you should be knowing from your theory. Sigma is equal to h rho rg by 2 cos theta. H is the water column height, rho density of the liquid, here it is water, or radius of the capillary tube, and g acceleration due to gravity, theta angle of contact. So h is equal to rho is mass by volume. So first time mass you take as m1, volume pi r squared h. Approximately the shape of water inside the capillary tube will be cylindrical, so pi r squared h, or radius of the capillary tube, g acceleration due to gravity, 2 cos theta. Mass by volume is density. Is it clear? Now you simplify this. This h and this h will cancel. This r, 1 r will cancel. So m1g by h has gone. So pi into r. This 2 cos theta is there here. So 1 by 2 cos theta. That is m1g by 2 pi r cos theta. Here given m1 is 5.0 gram. Similarly, for case 2, sigma is equal to m2g by 2 pi into 2r, because it is given 2r this time. Of course, cos theta. But both of them are equal. Both of them are giving the surface tension of water. Therefore, you can equate this and this. So, m1g by 2 pi r cos theta is equal to m2g by 2 pi 2r cos theta. Cancel out the common quantities. So you will get m2 is equal to this 2 will go to that side, because here 2 pi 2 pi, here r, here 2r, so this 2 will go to that side, so 2m1. M2 is equal to 2m1, given m1 is 5.0 gram, multiply by 2, 10.0 gram. Okay, so the answer is option 2. Next question. In Young's double slit experiment, if the separation between coherent sources is halved, that means made half, and the distance of the screen from the coherent sources is doubled, then the fringe width becomes option 1 half, option 2 4 times, option 3 1 fourth, option 4 double. So solution, this application is direct application of the formula. So you have to use the formula. Formula is beta equal to d lambda by d. Beta is fringe width, d lambda by d. This is the approximate sketch. Capital D is this distance between the plane of the slits and the screen. Small d is the distance between the slits. Lambda, of course, is the wavelength. After the changes, what are the changes? Separation between coherent sources is halved. So small d becomes d by 2. And the distance of the screen from the coherent sources is doubled. So capital D has become doubled. So 4d lambda here. So 2d lambda, doubled, no? So 2d lambda by d by 2. Now you simplify 4d lambda by d, which is, but d lambda by d is beta, so this is 4 beta. So what is the answer? It will increase 4 times. Next question. For the logic circuit shown, the truth table is, this is a circuit shown, 4 different truth tables are given. We have to identify what is the correct truth table. Of course, you can even use the De Morgan's laws to find out, but better than that, you can simply give the inputs and check the outputs. See A0, B0. First we give what happens to the output, we will check. You give A0, B0. But this is a NOT gate. So 0 will become 1. This is also a NOT gate. So 0 will become 1. Okay. So 1 and 1. But this is NOR gate. This bubble indicates it is NOR. If there is no bubble, it is R. So this is NOR gate. So it is not R. Okay. So 1 and 1, OR gate means it will be 1, but because it is NOR, it has to be 0. So 0, 0, 0 should be the first level input and output. So 0, 0, 0, so this is possible. 0, 0, 1 given here, not possible. 0, 0, 1 even here not possible. 0 0 0 possible. So either one should be correct or four should be correct. We'll have to check further. Now what we have to do, you go to the these inputs. Okay, that is we can check now. Same diagram is given here. Now you give 0 1 as the input, 0 1 NOT gate. So it has to be 1, it has to be 0. Then 1 and 0 given to NOR gate. OR gate means it will be 1, because it is NOR gate it has to be 0. So 0 1 0 should be there. Okay, the second one 0 0 1 0, but here 0 1 1 is given, so this is also ruled out. So coming to this 0 0 0 0 1 0, these two are correct. 0 0 0 0 1 0. So other things you need not check. Okay, if you want to check you can check, otherwise you can directly mark option 4 is the correct one. Okay, next question, it is about color code. The color code is given here. First two colors you have to consider, write the corresponding numbers one after the other. See, yellow, yellow is here, so 4. Then next one is violet, violet is here, so 7. So 47 you have to write. For third color you will have to go to this multiplier. Brown, so 10 to the power of 1, so 10 to the power of 1, 4 7, 10 to the power of 1. Then the last one is no even here, that is called tolerance, that is given by the fourth band of color. For gold it is 5%, right? So combining all this, 47 into 10 power 1 plus or minus 5%, 47 into 10 to the power of 1 is 10 to the power of 1 is 10, so 47 into 10 470, 470 plus or minus 5%, that has to be the answer, because 47 into 10 power 1, you know, it is 10. 470 plus or minus 5%, that should be the answer. Answer 3, correct option is 3. Okay, next one, the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with air as medium is 6 microfarad. Okay, let it be, with the introduction of a dielectric medium the capacitance becomes 30 microfarad. The permittivity of the medium is given, epsilon naught 8.85 10 to the power of minus 12 coulomb squared per newton per meter squared. Four options are given. 1.77 into 10 to the power of minus 12 coulomb squared per newton per meter squared. Second option, 0.44 10 to the power of minus 10 coulomb squared per newton per meter squared. Third option, 5.00 coulomb squared per newton per meter squared. Fourth option, 0.44 10 to the power of minus 13 coulomb square per newton per meter squared. Now here you have to understand one important thing. When a dielectric is introduced inside a capacitor, the dielectric should fully occupy the space. It is assumed here the capacitance increases by a factor epsilon r. Is it clear? So here the capacitance has increased from 6 to 30, so 5 times it has to be increasing. But the question is not asking about epsilon r, question is cleverly asking about permittivity of the medium, that is epsilon. So we have to find permittivity, which is epsilon, which is epsilon naught epsilon r. So epsilon naught given, epsilon r 5. Why 5? It has increased 5 times, so 5. Multiply these two, 44.5 10 to the power of minus 12. You just arrange it in such a way that you write it as 0.44 into 10 to the power of minus 10. See this? So option 2 is correct. Then a ball is thrown vertically up downward with a velocity of 20 meter per second from the top of a tower. It hits the ground after some time with a velocity of 80 meter per second. The height of the tower is, you are given g is equal to 10 meter per second squared. Option 1 340 meter, option 2 320 meter, option 3 300 meter, option 4 360 meter. Direct application, use the formula v square minus u square 2gh. Is it clear? He is asking height, so v square minus u squared by 2g, v given to be 80. You see, it hits the ground after some time with a velocity 80, u is 20. So 80 square minus 20 squared, 2 into g, g is 10, so 20 here. This is 100 into 60, use a square minus b squared formula, 8 plus 20, 100, 8 minus 20 is 60. 100 into 60 by 20, 20 into 20 and 60 will go 3 times, so 300 meter would be the answer. So option 3, Next question. Question number 25. A body weighs 72 newton on the surface of the earth. What is the gravitational force on it at a height equal to half the radius of the earth? You have to use the formula. G prime is equal to G by 1 plus H by R the whole square. This you might have studied from your theory. This is the formula for the variation with respect to height. Variation of acceleration due to gravity with respect to height. Multiply both sides by M. So mg prime is equal to mg. 1 plus h is equal to r by 2 given in the question. Height equal to half the radius of the earth. So r cancel. 1 plus 1 by 2. 1 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. Square is there. 72 is there. 3 by 2 the whole squared is 9 by 4. 4 will go to the numerator. 9 is here. So you will have to simplify this. 9 and 72, 8 times, 8 into 4, 32 newton. So answer is option 1. Is it clear? Then we go to the next one. Two particles of mass 5 kg and 10 kg respectively are attached to the two ends of a rigid rod of length 1 meter with negligible mass. The center of mass of the system from the 5 kg particle is nearly at a distance of option 1, 50 centimeter. Option 2, 67 centimeter. Option 3, 80 centimeter. Use the formula. Before that, you can just look at this diagram. This is, you take this to be the rigid rod of length 1 meter. 5 kg is at the origin. You take this to be the origin, M1. M2 is 10 kg. This M2 is here, 10 kg. Okay, don't consider M2 here. M2 is here, near 10 kg. M2 is 10 kg. This is the location of center of mass. But there is a formula for the center of mass. M1, X1, X1, X2 and all the distance from the origin. So center of mass is M1, X1. X1 is 0. That is distance of 5 kg from the origin. That is 0. X2 means distance of the second body from the origin, which is 1 meter. Mass of the second body, second particle, 10 into 1. M1 plus M2, 5 plus 10 is 15. So M1 into 0, 0, 10 by 15, 2 by 3 meter. Simplify, 0.67 meter, which will be 67 centimeter. So what is the correct option? Option 2. Okay, go to the next one. The increase in the width of the depletion region in a PN junction diode is due to option 1, reverse bias only. Option 2, both forward bias and reverse bias. Option 3, increase in forward current. Option 4, forward bias only. From your theory, you will know that reverse bias only is the correct answer. Okay, we'll go to the next one. Lighter frequency, 1.5 times the threshold frequency, is incident on a photosensitive material. What will be the photoelectric current if the frequency is halved and intensity is doubled? Option 1, 4 times. Option 2, 1/4. Option 3, 0. Option 4, doubled. So you should know what is this. For photoelectric effect to take place, the frequency of the incident light should be greater than the threshold frequency. That is important. See, initially frequency is 1.5 times threshold frequency. So photoelectric current would be available. But you see later on, frequency is halved. From 1.5 times, it is halved. Halved means half of this. 0.75 times threshold frequency. 0.75 times. Because it's halved, no photoelectric effect will take place because it's less than threshold frequency. Hence the photoelectric current is zero. So what should be the answer? Zero, because he's asking what will be the photoelectric current. Okay, thank you. We will meet in the next video. Thank you.